Yes. Okay, students. Good morning to all of you. So, in previous class, we discussed some concept about these capacitors. Okay, series combination, when two different types of dielectric materials are introduced, what happened to the capacitors? Okay, na? Yes. Students, see one more concept which is very important for you for objective, and sometimes they may ask you this type of questions for subjective 1 mark questions also and 2 mark questions also, Nana. Yeah. See, students, let us suppose when a dielectric material, dielectric material is placed between two plates of capacitors, between two plates of capacitor, when a battery is disconnected, what happens? Okay, let us see. Means what happened to this capacitance, what happened to the potential difference, what happened to the charge, what happened to the electrostatic energy of the capacitor. These are things let us discuss point by point. Okay. Yeah. Students, let us suppose here there is one capacitor. Okay, na? Whose capacitance is C. Okay. And that value is epsilon naught A by D. Clear, students? Now, into this capacitor, let us suppose one dielectric material having dielectric constant K is introduced, then capacity will become K times of epsilon naught A by D. Means it will becomes K times of initial capacitance. C dash is equal to K times of epsilon naught A by D is initial capacitance. Okay. So when the capacitance is increased, what happened to the potential difference? We need to check. Students, see here, this capacitor, whatever I am taking, for this, there is no batteries connected. Due to that, charge remains same. Charge will not same. This is, I am writing according to law of conservation of charge. Whatever you do the operation, because you are not adding charge, we are not subtracting charge. Charge remains same. This should be same. When battery is disconnected, when there is no battery. Now, because charge is same, but capacitance is increasing, then what happened to the potential? Yes, you know, potential Q is equal to CV, then V is equal to Q by C. See here, potential capacitance is increasing by K times, then potential will decrease by K times. Are you getting this? So potential will become V dash is equal to Q by C dash. That is Q by K times of original capacitance. So it will be original potential by K times. So potential is getting reduced by K times. Capacitance is increasing by K times. Okay, students? Yes. Now, let us suppose, yes, this is about potential difference. Now, what happened to the electric field? Yes. So, you know, electric field is this first point. I'll write point wise. First point, Nana. And this is the second point. Potential is increased by K times. See, my point is what? Potential. Then battery is disconnected, Nana. Okay. When there is no battery, charge remains same. This point you must remember. Okay. Yes. Now, what happened to the electric field? Yes, third point. Electric field. No, electric field, when electric field is uniform, you can write it as E is equal to V by distance. D is the distance between the two plates. Here or here. Okay. Since then, what happened to the electric field E dash? Here in this case, E dash will become V dash by D. Distance is not changing. So V dash is nothing but V by K divided by D. So V by D is nothing but E. So you let E by K. means electric field also getting reduced. Clear? Are you understanding? Yes, here V dash can be written as V by K, and here E dash electric field will become E by K. So when a dielectric material is introduced between the plates of a capacitor in such a condition that there is no battery connected, then capacity increased by K times, potential difference between the plates decreased by K times, and electric field also decreased by K times. Then what happened to the energy? Let us see. Yeah. So energy of this capacitor will become, you know, energy of the capacitor is half C V square. Or one point is constant here. Is Q is constant. You can take Q square by 2 C. This also you can take. Both with both the equations you will get same answer. Okay. Yes. Now I want U dash. U dash is nothing but half C dash V dash square. Yes. Half of C dash is nothing but K times of C into V dash is nothing but V by K whole square. So you will get half K times of C into V square by K square. 1K here, 1K cancel. You will get U dash equal to 1 by K times of half C V square. Half C V square is initial energy, let us take. So it will become initial energy by K times. So energy of the capacitor also get reduced by K times. This is I have done with half C V square. You can do the same thing with Q square by 2 C also. Since Q is constant, it will not change, whereas C is increased by K times. So here K C, right? It will become K outside, 1 by K times of Q square by 2 C will get. Means again you will get same answer. Are you getting? So I'll show you. So initial energy is Q square by 2 C. Yes. I want U dash. U dash is equal to Q dash square by 2 times of C dash. So Q dash is nothing but Q, because energy remains constant when battery is disconnected. So Q square by 2 times of C dash is nothing but K times of C. Yes, it can be written as 1 by K times of Q square by 2 C. So it is 1 by K times of initial energy, that is U by K. Again you got same. So better you, when you, whenever you want to find energy of the capacitor, better you use the equation in which one quantity is constant. Here Q is constant, so I'll use Q square by 2 C, so that easily I can get it. What is, students? Yes. Now let us discuss one by point by point. So for a capacitor, when a battery is disconnected and if you introduce a dielectric material between the plates of a capacitor, what happened? First point, because battery is not connected, there is no sources of charge, so charge remains same. So Q should be same. Okay. Yes. Q should be same. This should be same. Okay. Next. Next point, what, Nana? Yes. What happened to the potential? What happened to the capacitance first? Capacitance. Whenever dielectric material is introduced, capacitance will increase by K times. Yes. This will happen. Then what happened to the potential? Potential will get reduced by K times. Electric field will get reduced by K times. Energy also get reduced by K times. Okay. Next. Now let us keep the battery connected and introduce that electric material. What happened? Let us see. Yes. Insert a dielectric material between the two plates of a capacitor when a battery connected to it. Okay. Battery is connected, remains connected. Now in this case, let us insert a dielectric material. Okay. Now what happened? See, this is the capacitor. Now to this capacitor, let us imagine its capacitance is C, there is epsilon naught A by D. Now to this capacitor, let us suppose we have connected one battery. of voltage V. Clear?
Yes.
Now into this capacitor, now let us introduce a dielectric material. Yes, to this K dielectric material let us introduce. What happened? Battery remains connected. Students, first of all, its capacitance will become K times of epsilon naught A by D. That is, it will become K times of initial capacitance C. Here capacitance is epsilon naught A by D. Okay, na? Second point is, students, whatever you do for this capacitor, because battery remains connected, the potential difference between the plates of a capacitor remains there. So second point, na, this is first point. Second point, since battery is connected comma, the potential difference, important points, na, potential difference remains same. Very, 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 very important. Which remains same? In this case, potential difference remains same. Okay, na? Clear? Because battery is connected here. So, in this case, whatever the voltage is there, here V dash also you will get same V. Okay, na? Now, what about charge, sir? Now, yes, this battery is continuously charging this capacitor. Means charge is not same now, because there is a source of charge here. This battery is charging this capacitor continuously. So what happened to the Q dash? Yes. Here charge Q is equal to CV when there is no dielectric material. Whereas in this case, Q dash can be written as Q is equal to CV. No, yes, it is C dash into V, because V is remained same. Yes, C dash is nothing but K times of C into V. So it is K times of CV is Q. So Q dash will become K times of Q. Yes. So when a battery remains connected and a dielectric material is inserted between the plates of a capacitor, then its charge will increase by K times. When battery is not there, whatever you do, dielectric material, whatever you do, charge remains same. But battery is connected, and if you introduce a dielectric material, charge will increase by K times. Okay. Finished. Next. Fourth one, see, as potential is same, what about electric field? Students, electric field is nothing but V by D. Since V is same and distance is same, electric field also same. Or you can go with one more formula. Electric field formula is E is equal to sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Do you remember this one? Yes, electric field between the two plates of a capacitor. Sigma by epsilon naught. Yes, it is sigma by epsilon naught. Clear? Yes. So what is sigma, sir? Sigma is nothing but Q upon A divided by epsilon naught. So Q by A of epsilon naught. Sir, here Q is increasing, no, then A should increase. But when Q is increasing, epsilon naught also changing, no, because it is not free space now. It is filled with dielectric material. So Q is also becoming K times of Q, and A is same, but epsilon become K times of epsilon naught. This cancel, again you will get same electric field. So electric field remains same. I hope you understand clearly. Okay, na? So electric field between the plates of a capacitor remains same when battery is connected. Okay, yes. So E dash is equal to V dash by D, that is V by D, that is nothing but E. So electric field remains same. Okay, na? Next, what is there? Yes. What about the energy of the capacitor? Energy of a capacitor is half CV square, you know. Yeah. See, here I can use, here voltage is same, no? Yes, I can use this equation only. Then U dash can be written as half C dash V square, because V is same. Yes. half of c dash is k times of c, v dash is same. So you'll get k times of half c v square. So you'll get u dash is equal to k times of initial energy. So what happens, students? So when a battery is remains connected to it and a dielectric material is introduced, the capacity will increase by k times, potential difference remains same, charge will increase by k times, electric field remains same, but energy increase by k times. Okay, pure. And some students you may get one doubt that according to law of conservation of energy, energy cannot be created nor be destroyed, but how this energy is increasing, sir? Sir, no, clear? Yeah. Initially half c v square, but finally it is k times of half c v square. Means it is increasing. How it is increasing? See, students, here the capacitor plates are there. Okay. When you are trying to introduce this dielectric material, this with this dielectric material, you need to move this dielectric material towards this, into this. For this, you need to perform some work done. This work will be converted into energy and it will store in the capacitor as electrostatic potential energy in the form of electric field. Doubt clear? So how this energy will be introduced? And you can say sometimes the capacitor will get heated up. Did you observe? Yeah, that heating energy is due to increase in the energy of this capacitor. Means that energy may dissipate it to the surrounding in the form of heat, you can say. Clear? Yes, these two points you must remember. Okay, these questions they may ask for one mark also, Nana. You must remember these questions. Okay, here potential also same. You must remember these all the points. Okay, yes. Now let us move to next topic. Yes, students, sometimes they may ask you the questions like find the charge on each capacitor and what will be the potential across each capacitor, like that they may ask you. See, let us suppose, students, let us suppose here there are two capacitors are there like this. Okay, and the two capacitors C1 and C2 capacitances. And if these two capacitors are connected to a battery of V volts, let us suppose, then what happened? These two capacitors will get charged.
Yes.
Now my question is, what will be the charge on both the capacitors? How much charge will be there?
Remember, students, always, always in series combination, series combination, charge should be same. Charge should be same on all capacitors.
How much charge you will get later, but charge should be same. Okay?
Yes. See, here charge Q is there, means here also charge Q will be there.
Means what I am saying, here plus Q charge is there, means here minus Q charge will induce. Again, here plus Q charge will be used, here minus Q charge will be used. Total charge remains same on all the plates of the capacitor. Okay?
Yes.
So I am trying to show you this. So equal charge will be there. But how much charge is there? Let us find. Yes. Students, first find C equivalent. C equivalent in series can be written as C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Okay? Because values I have not given, this will be the answer. Okay, now I want charge on each capacitor. See, students, you know Q is equal to CV, and here C is C equivalent, and V is the voltage of a battery. Yes, so charge on each plate of the capacitor will be C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 into voltage. This much charge you will get. Okay, next question is, what will be the potential across each capacitor? Here potential how much, and here potential how much? Students, the potential, because charge is same, we know Q is equal to CV, then V can be written as Q by C. So V1 can be written as Q by C1 here, Q by C1. And similarly, V2, potential across second capacitor, can be written as Q by C2. I am writing Q because charge is same in series combination. means we can say V1 is to V2 will be in the ratio of C1 is to C2, 1 by C1 is to 1 by C2. Remember this point. Okay, with one numerical example, let us understand this. Okay, students, let us suppose here there are two capacitors are there. One capacitor is 3 microcoulomb and microfarad unit. 3 microfarad and another capacitor is 6 microfarad. Let us suppose 6 microfarad. Yes, these two are connected in series, and these two are connected together in series with a battery of, let us suppose, 10 volts. Let us suppose. Now my question is, what will be the charge on each plate of the capacitor, and what is the potential difference produced across each capacitor? This we need to find. So for finding charge, what need to do? First find C equivalent. Yes, C equivalent is nothing but C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Nana. Yes, C1 is 3 into C2 is 6 by 3 plus 6. So 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6 is 9. Okay, yes, 3 ones are 3 threes are 3 ones are 3 twos are. So it is 2. Unit is what? Microfarad. Yes, because in microfarad it is. C equivalent is 2 microfarad we got. Now we want charge. Charge can be written as Q is equal to C equivalent into voltage. Yes, 2 microfarad into 10 volts. So you'll get 20, 2 into 10, 20 microfarad into volt is nothing but coulomb. Yes, 20 microcoulomb is the charge. Yes, good. Okay, na? Now I want what is the voltage across first capacitor? Yes, voltage across first capacitor can be written as Q by C1. Yes, Q value 20 microcoulomb divided by C1 is 3 microfarad. Micro cancel. 3 1 the, yes, it is 20 by 3. You'll get 3 6 the 18. Something you'll get. Means let us keep it as it is 20 by 3 only. Okay. 20 by 3 volts. Yes. Now I want C2 value. Oh, sorry, V2 voltage across second capacitor. It can be written as Q by C2 is nothing but 20 microcoulomb divided by 6 microfarad. Yes, it is 20 by 6 volt. Again, if you add these two, 20 by 3 plus 20 by 6, you will get again 10 volts exactly. 6.666 is correct here. Okay, Nana? Yes, this type of questions, one simple questions you may get. Okay, na? Next, if you see a parallel combination, students, let us suppose, yes, parallel combination, let us take. Let us suppose here two capacitors are there, like this. One capacitor and another capacitor. And these two are connected in parallel across a battery of V volts, let us suppose. Here capacitor is C2, this capacitor is C1. Here battery voltage is V. Students, always you have to remember one point. Always in parallel combination, potential difference across each capacitor should be same, Nana. Okay, yeah, so whatever the potential difference is there here, same potential difference will be there here, which is equal to potential difference of a battery, because all three are in parallel. Okay, now second point is, how much charge this battery is giving to this capacitor, that charge will be distributed like this. Here Q1 charge, here Q2 charge. So total charge Q can be written as Q1 plus Q2. Nana. This point also you must remember. Okay. Now, how much charge is given? Let us find. Okay. See, first find C equivalent. C equivalent is in parallel combination, you know, C1 plus C2. Now total charge Q can be written as C equivalent into voltage. C equivalent is C1 plus C2 into battery voltage V. This much charge totally given. But what we need to find? we need to find charge on first capacitor and charge on second capacitor. This is the point we have to find. We don't want total charge. We want charge on first capacitor and charge on second capacitor. Students, you know, in a parallel combination, voltage is same. Clear enough? Yes, voltage can be written as Q by C. Okay, that means Q can be written as CV. That means Q1 can be written as C1 into V. Simply we can write. And similarly, Q2 can be written as C2 into V. Again add, you will get C1 plus C2 into V. Same answer you will get. Okay, na? Yeah, let us do this one with one example. Example let us take. Students, let us take again 2 microfarad capacitor and 4 microfarad capacitor and connect them both in parallel to each other. Screen share stop now. Okay. One more time I will share. Now is it visible to you, students? Is it visible? Yes, okay. Now, so these two are connected to, let us suppose it is 2 plus 6, 10, no? 2 plus 4, 10, 6. Okay. Now, 12 volts battery, let us suppose it is connected like this. 12 volt battery. Now, my question is, what will be the charge on first capacitor and what will be the charge on second capacitor? I want. Yes, how to find Anna? Yes, it is important. Yeah. Students, you know, ratio of charges in capacitors when they are in parallel is nothing but C1 is to C2. Is here C, Q1 is to Q2 can be written as C1 is to C2 because voltage is same. Clear, students? Yes. So you can write Q1 by Q2 can be written as C1 by C2. Can we write? Yes. Now let us add numerator to denominator. What you will get? C1 by C1 plus C2. Yes or no? Yes, we will get. Clear? Yes. Now it is Q1 divided by Q1 plus Q2 is nothing but total charge. Q is equal to C1 divided by C1 plus C2 is nothing but capacitors in parallel, equivalent capacitance. Okay, na? Yes, Q1 can be written as C1 into Q by capacitance in parallel. C1 value is 2 microfarad I have given into total charge Q. How to find? Yes, total charge Q is equal to C equivalent into voltage. Okay, na? Yeah. So C equivalent in C in parallel into voltage divided by C parallel. C parallel cancel, you will get voltage only. Means simply, if you don't want these all things, directly you can write. Because voltage is same, no? Here, see? Voltage is same. Yes. Sorry. Yes, we can get directly answer. Answer only you will get. These all are not required here. Because voltage is same on all the capacitors because they are in parallel. Here voltage how much? 12 volts. Directly we can say. Here also voltage how much? 12 volts. Okay. Then Q1 can be written as C1 into V, that is 2 microfarad into 12 volts. So we'll get 12 volts are 24 microcoulomb. 24 microcoulomb. And Q2 can be written as C2 into V, that is C2 is 4 microfarad into 12 volts. So you will get this 12 force of 48 micro coulomb. So if you want total charge, you can write Q1 plus Q2, that is equal to 24 plus 48. It is 72 micro coulomb total charge. Yes, good. Okay, now let us see some different combination. Series and parallel combination together, let us see. Okay, yeah. Students, it is important, this combination. Observe carefully. Let us suppose there are three capacitors are there. One capacitor is connected like this. Another capacitor is connected like this. And one more capacitor is connected like this.
Yes, and all these three capacitors are connected across a battery of let us suppose 6 volts battery. Okay, this capacitance you take 10 microfarad, you call it as C1, and this capacitor you call it as C2, that is 5 microfarad, and this capacitor you call it as C3, and that is 5 microfarad. Okay, na? Yes, students. Now I want what is the voltage across each capacitor and what is the charge on each capacitor I want. Okay, let us find this. Students, first thing what you have to do is find C equivalent for this combination. C equivalent we need to find now. Okay, yes. So for finding C equivalent, you need to find out which capacitors are in series and which capacitors are in parallel. Students, if you observe carefully, this battery 6 volts battery, no? Yes. So here across this, here 6 volts is there, here 0 volt is there. 6 minus 0 is 6 volts. Do you understand this concept? And this wire is connected because there is no nothing, a potential dropper is there. So here also 0 volt and here also 0 volt. This is also 0 volt. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Or else, sir, if you are not getting this 0, what is this 0 and 6? You imagine this point is A and this point is B. See, the point, this point is also B because there is no potential drop across this wire. This it is a connecting wire. And here also, this is also B and this is also B. Okay, students. Now, this point is something different because some different capacitors are there here. Capacitors are there across A and B. Now, let us call this as C. Okay, na? Yes. Now, students, see, now total there are 3 points are there, A, B, and C. Now, across these 3 points, these three capacitors are connected. Clear? Yes. So, let us do that same thing. Okay? See, how I am rearranging them, you have to observe. Okay, na? Yes. See, this point is you consider A. Now, for A, first capacitor, first plate is connected. C1 capacitor, first plate. Let us give naming also. First plate, second plate, third plate, fourth plate, fifth plate, sixth plate. What I am doing is I am arranging them according to one particular pattern so that I can get which are in series and which are in parallel. Okay? Yes. So first plate is connected. Now second plate is connected to point C. Okay, students? Yes. Let us connect second plate to point C. Second plate is connected to point C. Okay, students? Now, from this point C, two plates are connected. Third plate and fifth plate. Okay? Yes. So, I am doing the same thing. This is third plate and this is fifth plate. Are you getting, students? Yes. Now, third plate is having capacitance with the fourth plate. And fourth plate is connected to point B. Let us call this is point B. Sixth plate is, and fifth plate have an capacitance. And sixth plate is again connected to point B. Yes. This is again point B. These two are point B, let us suppose. Okay, na? Now, point between point A and B, 6 volts battery is there. Yes. So you can connect these two like this. Six volts battery. This is A, this is B. Got it? Now you got clear picture of capacitors. Which capacitors are in series, which capacitors are in parallel. This is C1. Third, fourth is C2. It is C2. C second capacitor. And this is third capacitor, C3. And then capacitance value also given, na? Yes. So what I am doing is here they have given like this. First, what you have to do is first you give naming for all the plates. This diagram I'll explain one more time. Give naming for all the plates. First plate, second plate, third plate, fourth plate, fifth plate, and sixth plate. Okay, na? After giving naming, you consider
there are two points across the battery, one point A, one point B. Imagine this may be PQ, it may be anything. Okay, now see, now this line, you see there is no extra capacitor, just it is a connecting wire. Here whatever the potential will be there, same potential will appear here also, same potential will appear here also, same potential will appear here also. Means these all the points are point B, and because here one capacitor is there, this is another point, and here one more capacitor is there, this is another point, which is not A, which is not B. So let us call it as C. Okay, now connect them, the plates, to their AB points. Now you got C2 and C3 are in parallel, and this total together in series. So you can say here you can say C2 and C3 are in parallel. We know C parallel is equal to C1 plus C2, that is C2 plus C3. C2 value given is 5 microfarad, and C2 value also 5 microfarad given. So parallel combination of these two capacitors together is 10 microfarad. Now these two together you can replace with only one capacitor, that is like this. See the diagram. Can you see this is first capacitor which I have shown you, and this is second capacitor. Okay, this is 10 microfarad, and this is already 10 microfarad given, C1 value, this C1. Now these two are connected across a battery of 6 volts. Now you can say these two capacitors are in series. We know series combination is equivalent is C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 formula. Yes, let us apply C equivalent 10 greatness, C1 value 10 microfarad into C2 value again 10 divided by 10 plus 10. So 10 into 10 by 10 plus 10 is 20. 0 0 cancel, it is 5 microfarad. Or simply, when two equal capacitors are connected in series, equivalent capacitance will become half of any one of the capacitor. You can directly say yes. So finally we got C equivalent is equal to 5 microfarad. Now we want total charge. Yes, you know total charge Q can be written as C equivalent into voltage. C equivalent is 5 microfarad and voltage is 6 volts. No, yes, 6 volts. So 5, 6 is 30. 30 microcoulomb. So total charge on the capacitor is 30 microcoulomb. Okay, Anna? Yes. But I want charge on each capacitor. Yeah. Students, I think so it is going to disconnect. So next class from here onwards I will explain. Okay, you let us stop here. In next class from here onwards I will explain, Anna, because Q1 if I short it will disconnect. Okay, na? Yes. Okay, na? Bye.